Hello everyone, let us now concentrate on the topic flow control valve in module 3, control components of fluid power system. So as the name itself suggests, flow control valve. Okay, so we are going to study how actually the flow rate is going to be controlled, okay, in case of the hydraulic system. So in this particular session, we will be studying the basic aspects of flow control valve, different types of flow control valve, okay, their constructional feature and working. So as the name itself suggests, flow control valve. So valves are the control components that leads to controlling the fluid flow here, as in case of flow control valve. Means to say that the flow control valve are the devices that controls the flow rate of the fluid. What is the purpose of going with the controlling of flow rate of the fluid? The controlling of the flow rate of fluid leads to the regulation in the speeds in the hydraulic actuator. So we have two types of actuator. One is linear actuator, that is piston cylinder arrangement like kind. Another one is rotary actuator, which are nothing but hydraulic motors. So to regulate the speed of hydraulic actuators, both linear and, you know, the rotary actuators, you are going to go with the controlling of the flow rate of the fluid that leads to the purpose. Okay, so here coming to the cases, we have, you know, major parameters that accounts for the flow control valve. Means to say that to control the flow rate of the fluid, there are few parameters which are accounted in the entire working principle. The first one being the opening or the orifice opening that leads to the amount of fluid to pass through the valve. The second one being the pressure of the fluid, and the third one being the temperature of the fluid. Okay, so pressure, temperature and orifice opening are the parameters that leads to the functionality or description of different types of flow control valve. So we have two types of flow control valve. One is non-compensated, another one is compensated. Here the term compensated goes with the parameters called as pressure and temperature. As the name itself suggests, it is non-compensated flow control valve. These are the flow control valves that doesn't depend or that doesn't compensates on the variation in the flow rate, which are accountable due to pressure and temperature. So whenever the flow rate in the entire hydraulic system, if it is affected due to the pressure and temperature, at that particular point of time, the valves which will not compensate that variation, that those are called as non-compensated flow control valve. Whereas if the valve has the capacity of compensating the changes in the flow rate that is accountable due to pressure and temperature, they are called as compensated flow control valve. So to, you know, to go with the brief description here, so non-compensated flow control valve works on the principle or assumption that the flow through the orifice will be constant if the pressure drop remains constant. Means to say that whatever may be, you know, the variation in the pressure or temperature that is leading to the flow, leading to the variation in the properties of fluid, but the flow rate through the orifice, that is through the opening in the valve, will always be constant considering the pressure drop is constant. Okay, so again, it doesn't compensate for any of the variation in flow rate that is due to pressure and temperature. So different types of non-compensated valves are needle valve, globe valve and gate valve. Okay, so here it is purely the opening of the orifice that leads to the flow rate of the fluid in the hydraulic system. Okay, moving on with the next one, that is compensated flow control valve. Here whenever there is a variation in pressure or variation in the flow rate that is accountable due to pressure and temperature. So how we measure is that the major parameter of viscosity in the fluid. So viscosity is one particular parameter in the fluid that is going to be affected by pressure and temperature, because the same fluid is considered for the multiple number of working cycles throughout the hydraulic system. So hence what happens, the variation in the viscosity that is due to the pressure and temperature, that will be accounted here by automatically changing the valve adjustment opening. Okay, once we go with the construction, we are going to study or justify to this particular statement. So it is the adjustments wherein we concentrate on the valve opening to accomplish or to compensate the variation in viscosity parameter that is due to pressure and temperature is what we go with in case of compensated flow control valve. In compensated flow control valve, we have two types. One is pressure compensated, another one is temperature compensated flow control valve. So in case of pressure compensated, we have restrictor type of valve as the example here. Here, in when it comes to pressure compensated and temperature compensated, if we try to go with the modification in the valve opening to compensate the variation in the pressure, then it is considered as pressure compensated flow control valve. Similarly, for the variation in the flow rate, that is due to the temperature, or the variation in the viscosity parameter due to the temperature, if we operate the valve opening or if we modify the valve opening, then we are going to consider that as temperature compensated. It is as simple as like automatically modifying the valve opening based on the variation of pressure, it becomes pressure compensated. If it is due to temperature, it becomes temperature compensated flow control valve. Now, let us go with the construction and working of different types of flow control valve. So, we have five here as an example. One is needle valve, globe valve and gate valve, which are accountable under non-compensated flow control valves. Whereas in case of compensated flow control valve, we have pressure compensated and temperature compensated valves. So, if you just observe the figure here, okay, so this is a simple non-compensated flow control valve that directly depends, or the name is directly derived based on the type of opening provided or the projection in which the opening stem is being concentrated. So you can just have a look at this particular diagram here. Here, this is a pointed conical extended projection in the stem here. So that is accountable to be of a design of needle type. Hence the name needle flow control valve. So here what happens, based on the rotation what you feed to the stem, okay, along the upward direction, you are going to take this particular needle or the extended projection at the bottom to move off its position, to move off its initial position. So usually what happens, this particular needle come to its original position such that the valve body gives clear closure to the opening of the valve. Means to say that the extended projection in the stem, that is the needle part of the entire valve here, will be closed perfectly through the valve body. But once you start providing the rotational moment to the through the stem or to the needle valve here, what happens? This particular needle will move off its position, creating the opening between inlet and outlet. Means to say that this is the position wherein which the needle will be complete, needle will be in its closed condition, wherein no flow is being achieved from inlet to outlet. Whereas once the needle is being moved off its seat, there will be flow taking place from inlet to outlet. Now comes the concept of flow rate. So as I said, in case of non-compensated flow control valve, it is basically the opening provided at the orifice that leads to the flow rate in the fluid. So here what happens, as the opening increases, the passage for the flow of fluid from inlet to outlet increases. Keep in mind, as the opening or as the needle move away from its position, move upwards in its position, what happens? There will be more amount of space provided for this, for the fluid to move from inlet to outlet. So based on the amount of flow wherein you are needed at the end of outlet, you are going to keep the position of needle at that particular height, that leads to that amount of opening between the inlet and outlet. So means to say that lower the height, then lesser will be the flow rate. So height, if you increase the height, flow rate will be more. Okay, so here one of the major advantage of needle type of flow control valve is that you can get a very fine quantity of fluid moving through the outlet. Means to say that a very sharp amount of flow rate can be achieved through needle type of non-compensated flow control valve. Moving on with the next one, the globe valve. Here what happens, as in the same case of the stem, stem, instead of a needle or a conical projection, we will be having a disc, a plate like structure, which is accountable for its position to close the opening from inlet and outlet. So means to say, the position of the disc will be such that it will not allow the flow of fluid from inlet to outlet. But when you need the flow to, when you need a particular amount of flow rate of the fluid, what you do is, again you are going to, you know, provide the rotational force to this particular stem through the hand wheel such that the disc or the plate move away from its position. So as it moves away from its position, it creates a space wherein the fluid can flow from inlet to outlet. So disc is taken upward direction, so there is a flow from inlet to outlet. The major difference between needle and globe valve is that the type of opening provided due to the orifice or the disc here. So here what happens, maximum amount of flow rate is achieved than the needle valve, because the space or the position in which disc is considered will have huge amount of area that gives opening for the maximum amount of fluid to pass through the system, but it's from inlet to outlet. So in comparison with the needle valve, you will be having better flow rate or greater flow rate than the needle valve in case of globe valve. Moving on to the third type of non-compensated flow control valve, the gate valve. So these are the valves which are generally used in agricultural lands, wherein the flow of fluid from a channel or a canal is supposed to be taken to the land. Okay. So here what happens, as in case of needle and globe, it is the extended projection at the end of the stem. So this particular portion is called as stem here. So here it was a conical pointed type of projection which looks like a design of a regular needle. Whereas in case of globe valve, it is the position or the design is such that it looks like a plate or a disc at the end of stem. Whereas in case of gate valve, it will be a rectangular plate or a trapezium plate that leads to the provision of inlet or provision of flow between the inlet and outlet in case of flow control valve. So here you can observe, this is a particular portion that is considered to be the gate here. So the gate may be of rectangular in its shape or may be of trapezium in its shape, but the position of closing and opening will always be with respect to the vertical axis. Means to say that the entire plate will be considered vertically aligned between the inlet and outlet. So it gives a complete closure between inlet to outlet here. So this is something called as gate valve. When it comes to the flow rate here, so rather than in a needle and globe valve, the flow rate is maximum in case of gate valve. But just because it gives you maximum flow rate, you cannot consider gate valve in all the application. Wherever the flow rate is required, at whatever extent it is to be taken or derived, based on that quantity, we are going to target different types of non-compensated flow control valves. Okay. So this is one particular symbol that represents flow control valve here. Okay. So basically for non-compensated type of flow control valve, for all these three valves, we can use this particular symbol. In particular, in case of any of the hydraulic system, okay, maximum utility factor goes with needle valve. Hence, so this is the preferred one in case of hydraulic system, wherein a very fine flow rate is being achieved, or very fine flow rate is required for the operation of hydraulic system. Okay. So this is about non-compensated type of flow control valves. Moving on with the major part, compensated flow control valve. See, how do the term automatically changes the valve adjustments and valve adjustment opening? How do we justify this particular statement is that, see, we will be having the components which are assisted with the spring force here. Okay. So based on that particular force, if the pressure or temperature exceeds, the orifice opening will be compensated or automatically controlled. So keep this in mind, when the pressure or temperature increases, we are going to have a mechanism that leads to the control of opening of the orifice automatically to compensate that particular flow rate due which is delayed or which is reduced due to the increase in pressure and temperature. Okay. So it has to be remembered like this. If the flow rate is affected by pressure and temperature, that affected flow rate should be changed to the required flow rate by compensating the variation which is due to pressure and temperature. So make this particular statement very clear. Means to say that when the pressure of the fluid which is coming, you know, when the fluid which is coming at a particular pressure, if the pressure increases, if the temperature increases, then how we open or how we give the opening to the orifice leads to the concentration of the compensated flow control valve. So you can observe the first one here, it is restrictor type of compensated pressure compensated flow control valve. Okay, so here this is a throttle and this is a spool. Spool is assisted by a hydrostat piston which is in support with the extended spring here. Okay, so this is a source from pump and this is a source to the load or to the system wherein the flow is to be taken. Okay, so this is the entire structure is called as valve body. The major aspect of concentration here should go with the throttle. So you can observe this particular representation here. I have a shaft. On the surface of the shaft, I have a groove cut along the surface of the shaft. Means to say that this is where the throttle is to be understood when we are going with the understanding of compensated flow control valves. So this is a shaft on which on the surface a groove is cut. Okay. When this particular shaft is rotated along the direction of fluid flow, okay, means to say that when you rotate this particular throttle towards the inlet or to a position wherein the maximum amount of flow can lead from pump to the system is what it is to be understood here. Okay, so here what happens, we will be having a spool which is fixed with, you know, which is in contact with the hydrostat piston. Okay, the position of spool and the position of hydrostat piston against the spring pressure is kept such that there is a minimum opening or the required amount of opening provided for the fluid to flow through pump to the system. Okay, so this is the focusing area here. So here is what the amount of opening is given for the fluid to flow from pump to the load. So thereby what happens, this orifice opening will be kept such that for a particular or optimum pressure, the orifice is directly related to give maximum flow rate or to required flow rate to the entire hydraulic system. What happens if the pressure of the fluid increases? If the pressure of the fluid increases at that particular point of time, what happens? This particular spool, which is now leading to a particular amount of opening from the for the inlet, thereby what it does, if the pressure increases, this particular spool move off its seat. Once it move off its seat, what happens to the orifice or the opening here? The opening becomes closure or the opening becomes reduced, you know, leads to reduction in the quantity of fluid to flow through it. At that particular point of time when the pressure increases, what we do is we are going to keep this throttle to a condition wherein it is rotated such that maximum amount of area or the valve comes in picture with the or comes in contact with the flow of fluid. Though there is an increase in the movement of the hydrostat in term with respect to spring or movement of spool with respect to hydrostat piston due to the increase in pressure, what we do is to compensate this reduction in the orifice due to the increase in pressure, what we do is we are going to create a system so that the throttle is opened and maximum amount of opening comes in contact with the fluid. So thereby what happens, though the pressure is increased, though the orifice opening is reduced now, but for the whatever the amount of fluid which is coming into the system here, that is being provided with maximum surface contact with the throttle valve so that the flow rate is compensated. Though the orifice is reduced now, or the dimension orifice is bit reduced to the initial stage, what we are doing, we are rotating the throttle such that for whatever the fluid which is coming inside the valve body, it is being made to, you know, come in contact with maximum opening on the surface such that the flow rate is reached as it was working before the increase in pressure of the fluid. So this is how a pressure compensated flow control valve works. Okay, moving on with the last one, it is temperature. So again, similar to that of pressure compensated flow control valve, okay, we have temperature compensated flow control valve. Here the entire aspects of temperature leads with respect to the viscosity of fluid. So based on how the temperature is relevant to the viscosity of fluid, here the same thing will be accountable even in considering the opening of the orifice. So keep this in your mind. So whenever we go with again compensated type of valve, based on the variation you are going to create the opening of the valve, means to say that you are going to make sure that the orifice is been increased, the dimension at the orifice is increased so that the flow rate is kept constant. Okay, here what happens again in the valve body, we have a compensator piston here. So based on the requirement or the necessity of the fluid to run at a particular temperature in the hydraulic system, through this particular valve what we do is we are going to position the piston against the spring pressure such that whatever the fluid which is coming into the valve is sent out of the valve body at a particular or a particular flow rate. Okay, so here what happens if the pressure, I mean if the temperature increases, okay, if the temperature increases, thereby what we do is that you are going to make sure that, okay, so this is the orifice, adjustment orifice, and this is the temperature sensor element here. So the temperature sensing element directly goes with the viscosity of the fluid. So what happens if the viscosity of the fluid, okay, is affected by the temperature, if the flow rate is affected by the temperature of the fluid, at that particular point of time what happens, this particular, you know, the temperature sensing element moves off its position so that it reduces the opening provided here. So this is the orifice of, you know, orifice that leads to the flow of fluid from inlet to outlet. So at that particular point of time, since the temperature is increased, since the viscosity is affected based on the temperature, what it does is that it tries to move towards the left side as in case of the figure here, such that the orifice opening is reduced. Once the orifice opening is reduced, what happens? Then definitely it leads to reduction in the flow rate. To compensate this reduction in the flow rate, what happens is that this particular compensator piston will be now taken against the spring here. So when it is taken against the spring, at the inlet itself, the quantity of fluid will be more, which is entering into the valve, that compensates the, you know, the flow rate which was affected due to the temperature of fluid. Okay, so this is about the compensated flow control valves here. So this is the symbol that represents for the pressure compensated flow control valve, and this is the symbol that represents for the temperature compensated flow control valve. So this is all about flow control valve for today's session. Thank you.